Oh, wow.
Door. You can't even get out.
Look at that.
All right. Are you going to come help?
I can't get out.
All right.
Are you filming?
Yeah, hold this.
Okay.
Probably just pull it out. Anyway. How did you even manage this?
I don't know. Skill, luck. From the best driver.
It's destroying the paintwork.
Oh crap, I'm sorry.
It's okay. Have you seen the rest of the paintwork on this vehicle?
That's true.
How did you do this?
Is it... I don't think you can quite see it. Yeah. I just wanted to take some of the forest with us. Is that so bad? Come on, Wessels.
I'm trying to break it without destroying the paintwork in too much.
Maybe use your chainsaw.
Here, I can just put it this way.
That seems ill-advised.
Well, it's like the most flexible branch.
When I pick them right.
Oh, maybe I can get out this way now. I bent it.
Oh, how long is it?
There. This is what you picked up.
Yeah.
It's blocking you in. Not too much damage to the paintwork. Just a few scratches.
Sounded awful.
It did sound pretty bad. But it matches some of the other scratches. All the Kentucky scratches. This one's a good one from Kentucky. So normally when I do these videos, I like to walk around, but this time I'm gonna stay pretty much where I am because I am right on the edge of the Grand Canyon. Now we couldn't go to the north rim into the actual national park itself because it's closed, although technically just a few feet that way the Grand Canyon National Park starts, but I'm not gonna be visiting it because it's quite a steep entrance. In fact, it's a very long way down. If I go stand on the edge there, So, no, you know what, I'm not going to do it. It's a really long way down. So we're out here at this viewpoint. I think it's Saddle Mountains just over there. And we're going to try and find somewhere to camp somewhere along the ridge up here, preferably somewhere with some views. It is National Forest just up there. So if I can find a good place, I can put the drone up just as the sun's setting. It's a beautiful spot here. I don't know if you heard that, but Elizabeth's getting spooked by bees. She absolutely hates insects to the point where she has actually opened the car door to get out of the car while it's moving with her seatbelt still on because there was a bee in the car. So I'm kind of concerned that she's gonna do the same kind of thing here with bees and the edge. Don't
it
jump.
Would be rational.
Yes, she has an irrational fear of bees and insects. Where it wouldn't surprise me if she jumped off the edge just to avoid a bee. From the viewpoint, it was a short drive north to a spot that I had seen on the satellite map layer on Gaia GPS that looked like a great spot for camping. How about this for a camp spot? It has views. Now, it's not views of the canyon. The canyon's up there, the other side of those hills, so you can't see the actual Grand Canyon, but you can see for miles all around.
So from up here, you can see for miles. You can see a lot of the places we've been. So day before yesterday, we were driving along those cliffs up there in the distance to go up into Page, which is somewhere up there. And then from Page, we went behind the cliffs that you can see there. And then stayed somewhere up. It's kind of hard to see on the camera. Somewhere up there, and then drove down these cliffs this morning and up onto the plateau there.
The next morning, we drove north, down from the Kaibab Plateau, and across the state border into Utah. We are back up in Utah. We just crossed over, just over the border from Arizona. We're at Coral Pink Sand Dunes State Park, and I don't know if it shows up on the camera, but the reason it's called Coral Pink is because of the very pink color that it's got. It's not like the sand of the other sand dunes I've been to. And at this state park, you're actually allowed to, both you're allowed to fly a drone and you're allowed to drive on the sand dunes. So I'm hopefully going to do a little bit of both. The woman at the reception said not to drive on the sand dunes. She said I'd get stuck because the sand's too soft. So hopefully that doesn't happen. Let's find out.
With a piece in my hand and bloodshot eyes, I walk to the water for a last goodbye. He begged so much, it clouded my mind. One thing's clear, the man's gotta die. Man makes right, so he said, when he yelled all the keys over our head. I lived in that grip, but now he'll learn at the end with the tables turned. Lord, forgive me. Take me on down the river where the kids can't find a red-handed sinner. On where the grave can't cry out. Cause I done wrong down the river with a hand on a Colt and a finger on the trigger. And on before dawn they try to find me. So take me on down. Take me on down. I sank that body by the riverbank. Caught a boat staff, took off like a hurricane. With spotless dogs, hit the whole nine yards. And breathing down my neck and breathing hard. 2 weeks in a wild chase across the highways, mountains over seven states. Found a man at the harbor, said that he could take me across the ocean somewhere far away. Lord, forgive me. Take me on down the river where the kids can't find. Down
Just as she was getting the hang of driving on the soft sand, Elizabeth took on a dune that was a little larger than she had expected. She had panicked and slammed on the brakes, bringing us the closest we'd ever been to rolling a vehicle.
Just looking at this. Alright, so the back is dug in, so you're gonna have to give it very little gas. Should we put off the brake?
Yes.
Alright, give it very little. Keep going, okay. Keep going, a little more. Go on, keep going. Alright. You're out. You need to start steering now.
No, I don't want to. Time for you to drive.
Okay. Let me get the drone then.
I'm done.
From coral pink sand dunes, it's maybe about a mile to the Utah Traverse. Within a mile more, Elizabeth was back in the driver's seat and driving the sandy trails like she was competing in the Baja 1000.
No, just go forward like you've got it. No, just drive very slowly forward. No, stop. Oh, this isn't good. Maybe time to run the winch.